Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. I hope everybody's having a great day. There's been another kind of a recall, customer satisfaction program, and it's dealing with the transmission. We're going to talk about the transmission, and I'm going to show you, I actually have the part to show you what is wrong while they're doing this customer satisfaction program. So let's get into it. All right, you can see it right here. This is from February 21st. Okay. Says customer satisfaction program 25B01, certain 24 model year F-150 Mustang Expedition Navigator Transit Super Duty and 25 model year Explorer vehicles equipped with the 10R80 or the 10R100 transmission. So what they're saying is wrong with it. Well, if you look here, it says 398 vehicles affected. I'm sure that's going to be more at some point. And it's telling that the one-way clutch mechanism were built with the wrong size roller bearings. If the OWC, which is the one-way clutch mechanism, fails due to undersized roller bearings, the vehicle will experience limited gear availability. In most cases, the one-way clutch will lock in the on position, restricting the vehicle to 1st, 2nd, 8th, 9th, and 10th gear and reverse. The customer may experience noise and vibration. Additionally, a wrench light may be present, and the cluster display screen, accompanied by a diagnostic trouble code P2701 and a 0757, indicating a malfunctioning transmission system. We're going to talk about this a little bit, and I'm going to show you what the one-way clutch looks like. This is a one-way direct drive, one-way clutch. Spins one way. Does not spin the other. You can see this one was worn out. This actually came out of a 6R140 torque shift. So similar. I don't have an exact one that came out of the new 10R140, but you can see all these wear marks on here. And this is the planetary gear set. And I do believe that one of the bearings they're talking about, there's one that sits on top of here. There's another gear down inside here. And then there's that guy, which I can't get out, but see if I can go through this way and get him out. See if I can hook it. I don't think I can get it out, because it's on the gears here. Yeah, it's stuck on the gears there. But you get the drift. There's one there. This sits down. If I can get it to sit, oh, got it upside down. Nope, I don't. Down in there, and then this one, and then there'll be another one that sits up on top here. So what's going to happen, it's not going to allow it to lock from what I'm reading correctly, and it's going to, you'll get some erratic shifting, and what was it, 1, 2, 8, 10th and reverse. But you can see this one's got some major wear on it. This one actually had like 549,000 miles on it. This is the one I tore down before. If you didn't see that video, I'll leave it down up in a card or down at the bottom somewhere. But I also want to talk to you about the 10-speed transmissions and where that came from. Those 10 speeds were actually, and it might be this thrust bearing that sits inside here too that they're talking about. I didn't even look at the diagram, but I know it's one of those roller bearings in there somewhere that fails. Now, like I said, it was what, 300 something vehicles? But the reason I think it's going to be more is because those 10 speeds back in 2013, actually, is when they announced that they're merging with GM or Chevrolet to build this 10 speed. So the 10 speed is longitudinal, and you have the 10R80 and the 10R140. The 10R means 10 speed rear wheel drive, 80, which is like 800 newton meters, which is 590 foot pounds. That's what the numbers mean. And that was put in mid 2017 on the F-150. And then in 2020, the Super Duty saw the 10R140, which is 10 speed rear wheel drive, 1400 newton meters, which is 1032 foot pounds. We've had so many transmission problems ever since they decided to do a 10 speed with GM. Everybody knows GM has transmission problems. So why would they take the 6R80 or the 6R140 torque shift, which was a good transmission? This one lasted for 549,000 miles. Why would they take a good transmission and then merge with a company that has transmission problems, and then now both companies have transmission problems? I don't get it. But that is, they were actually in talks of that in 2013. And then they finally did it for the mid 2017 F-150. And like I said, 2020, the Super Duty is when they got the 10 speed. They got CDF clutch drum or CDF drum problems. They apparently have this bearing problem now, valve body issues. Just the list goes on and on and on. And quite frankly, I'm tired of doing transmissions. So that is what the OWC one-way clutch looks like. That is out of a six-speed. That's out of a 2014 model, I do believe. The one that's inside the 10R140 and the 10R80, which is the 10-speed, does look a little bit different than that one. I get it. You know, what I'm trying to say is manufacturers combine things all the time. Like, not one manufacturer has its own thing. They all have things from different manufacturers. And if they could just put their brains together instead of trying to mass produce these things and actually do a good quality control and make sure things like this don't get missed and do correct measurements and things like that, like they tell us to do when we rebuild them, then we wouldn't have these problems. But then again, they wouldn't be making any money because you wouldn't be buying a transmission or you wouldn't be buying a new vehicle every 5 years. It's all about making money. So, but the fix for that one is not to replace the one-way clutch. It's actually to replace the whole transmission. I'm sure there's going to be more, and there's only 300 something of them that you see right now that is on that customer satisfaction program. So without further ado, and with all that being said, hope you learned a little bit of something. I love you guys, and I'll see you on the next one.